Hello everyone, my name is Ankita Shah and welcome you all to our next session, that is Functions of Human Resource Management. In our last session, we discussed the meaning of HRM as well as we discussed that how HR has proved its importance to the organizations in last few years. Today in this session, we are going to discuss those functions of human resource management which makes it an indispensable and imperative part of the organization. So the first main important function of human resource management is operational functions. Operational functions are the functions which help the organization to operate its day-to-day business activities. The next important function of human resource management is managerial functions. Managerial functions helps in planning, organizing, staffing, directing, controlling of employees. And the next main important function of HRM is advisory functions, under which comes up advice to top management as well as advice to departmental heads. In today's session, we are going to discuss only operational functions in detail. So let us proceed with the first main important function of HRM, that is operational functions. Guys, operational functions plays an important role within the organization because it helps in building a good team of working professionals for operating the business activities. Of course, without proper manpower, you cannot get any job done on time. To operate the business activity, proper personnels with required skills are required. And here, operational functions plays an important role. So let us proceed with the first main operative function of operational functions, that is recruitment. Guys, recruitment in any organization is an ongoing process, and that is why it is an important operative function. Because due to the recruitment only, employer get the proper manpower within the organization who can help the organization to achieve the required objectives. But before you are initiating the recruitment process, it is very much necessary that you have the plan ready in your hand, that how much manpower you need in future, what are the numbers you require, plus what are the skills which you require basically to get any particular task done. A lot of elements go into this function of recruitment, like developing a job description, developing a job analysis, publishing the job posting on various portals, or you know, sourcing the prospective candidates, then interviewing them, and then finally salary negotiation, and then providing them with an offer letter. So it is a complete process. You cannot put recruitment on hold for a while. That's why I'm telling you it's an ongoing process, because now suppose if you have hired one candidate in a single month, it is not going to happen that in the coming month as well, you will not be requiring any candidate. Of course, you will be requiring someone with some new skill. And that is why recruitment plays an important role. The next important operative function of HRM is induction and orientation. Induction and orientation is the process of make the employees feel comfortable within the organization. It is the process of acquainting the employees with the policies and the procedure of the organization, as well as meeting them with the staff members, or arranging a meeting with the management, or having them a tour of the office premises or the office area and things like that. What if you gonna put on job on the very first day of your joining? You will not feel connected with the organization, of course, because you were not given a proper induction and orientation before that. So that is why induction and orientation is a very important process, a very important function of HRM. The next main important operative function of HRM is training and development. It is kind of a follow-up of employment. Training and development is a process of developing employees' technical skill for the job they have been hired, as well as develop them for higher jobs within the organization. This helps in both employees' and employers' growth. Training and development plays an important role in any organization because with the changes of technology, with the changes of the skill required within the organization, a proper training is required to provide the employees. And HR plays an important role here because under the HR function only, HRs or the employer get to know that where and when the training need is required. There are so many on-the-job and off-the-job training methods are to be used for developing the employees. Now, it is in HR's responsibility to make sure that both old and new employees get the required training. The next important operative function of HRM is compensation and benefits. Compensation and benefits plays the role of a motivator within the organization. It is this function basically is related to determine accurate remuneration of the employees towards their contribution to the organization's goal or the activities. Compensation and benefits basically refers to the compensation or salary or any other monetary or non-monetary benefits passed on by a firm to its employee. It helps to keep the employees motivated and brings the best out of them at workplace. Now, if in case you are not getting proper salary against the work you are doing for any organization, you will not feel that motivated or that connected. Salary or the benefits plays an important role in motivating the employees. It works as a stimulator. That is why it is very much necessary that your employees are getting paid on the basis of their knowledge, their skill, as well as the work they are doing within the organization. Usually, HR people arrange a lot of extensive wage surveys to get to know that if their employees are paid properly on the basis of the industry's requirement or not. The next main important operative function is motivation. It is an important function because if the employees are not motivated, they don't contribute towards organization's goal as much as they can. To motivate the employees, it is necessary that their various needs like timely appraisal, salary increment, future growth is being properly taken care of. Other than the salary increments or future growth and things like that, there are so many other motivational factors as well, like some kind of benefits or some kind of crash facility or gymnasium or things like that. These things also plays in motivating the employees. The next important operative function of HRM is personal records. Under this function, all employees' records from the joining till separation are to be maintained. Recording, maintaining and retrieving employees' related information like application forms, employment history, working hours, leave record, employee turnover, promotion, increment, so many things are a part of personal record. Under this function, you have a thorough knowledge that where the files are being put up or like in particular in like by when a particular employee get an increment or a promotion or by when any particular employee joined the organization or like in a given month how many employees applied for a particular job in your organization. So basically all these things are to be maintained under personal records. This data basically helps in getting all the required information when the need arises. Now suppose in case you need some information after 2 years or after 3 years, what are you gonna do? Personal records plays an important role here because you can get the required data in just few seconds. Next important operative function is maintenance, that is safety and welfare of the employee. For a smooth functioning of any organization, it is very much necessary that employees feel safe and secure within the organization. Plus, they are being provided with good working conditions so that their efficiency can be increased. Along with various welfare services, along with the safety and security and measures applied for their comfort, there are so many welfare services as well which needs to get provided to the employees. These services include gym, yoga, cafeteria, recreational activities, employee engagement activities and so many other things. The next important operative function of HRM is industrial relations. Maintaining good industrial relations nowadays is an HR's job. Whether it is settlement of disputes, grievance handling within the employees, collective bargaining or managing the strikes held by the trade unions due to the salary or wage increase or something like that. Everything is being handled by HR people only and it is their responsibility to maintain a peace within the organization. So guys, this was all about the operative functions of human resource management. I tried to make every point clear in front of you. Still, if you need some kind of assistance or clarification is required, you can put your comments below. In our next session, we will have a look about managerial function as well as advisory function of human resource management. Thanks a lot. See you soon.